It was a game so iconic, it inspired the name of a microgeneration. Early 80s babies know all too well the dangers of dying of dysentery on the Oregon Trail, but what are the chances of losing a member of your party to it these days? Typhoid fever is caused by the Salmonella typhi bacteria, which gets into your body via contaminated water or food. Then it lives in your intestines, and you spread it around by going to the bathroom and not washing your hands. As you might imagine, for folks traveling the Oregon Trail, proper sanitation wasn't easy, and as a result, typhoid was pretty common. Typhoid causes a severe fever, weakness, and a loss of appetite, all of which can easily lead to death, especially if you're in the middle of the wilderness, 100 miles from any sort of medical care, and a century or so away from modern science. You might think that a disease that can be prevented by boiling water and washing your hands is probably eradicated in the glorious future, and you'd be wrong. According to the World Health Organization, about 11 million people get typhoid every year, and somewhere around 110,000 people die from it.
What's going on, Diaz? Are you sick?
Do you have cholera? Is it typhoid?
The danger depends entirely on where you live. In the United States, there are only about 5,700 estimated cases annually. But you're not entirely safe from an old-timey disease. WZTV reports that there were 71 cases reported in early 2021, prompting an alert from the CDC because 9 of the victims had not traveled outside the country, indicating a potential outbreak. An incredibly contagious viral illness, measles was once one of the most common diseases in the world. It's so contagious that once exposed, usually when an infected person coughed or sneezed near you or touched you after touching their mouth or nose, you were more or less guaranteed to get sick. Once you're sick, you'd get a telltale rash that would spread all over your body, a dangerously high fever, cough, runny nose, and sore throat. The College of Physicians of Philadelphia notes that most people survive the infection, but low-income nations can have a higher mortality rate. As many as 28% of the infected suffer severe complications that can lead to death. Measles was so common, it was accepted as a fact of life. At some point, as a kid, you were going to get measles, be miserable for a week or two, and then be immune to it for the rest of your life. Unless it, you know, killed you. Considering all the other hardships on the Oregon Trail, it's little wonder your family died so often from it in the game. In the mid-20th century, the disease was still responsible for hospitalizing 48,000 Americans every year, killing around 500. The good news is that measles is one of the earliest vaccine success stories. The Center for Disease Control and Prevention reports that since a vaccine was introduced in 1963, there are typically fewer than 1,000 cases each year in the United States. Cholera and dysentery are different diseases, but they kill you the same way. Endless, horrifying diarrhea that results in dehydration.
Cholera! You know cholera?
The black
The black The latest offering in the Frontiers Disease of the Month Club.
A waterborne bacterial disease, what sets cholera apart is how fast it kills you. It can result in death in just a few hours. According to the U.S. National Park Service, cholera was one of the primary causes of death to settlers heading west along the Oregon Trail, and the National Oregon-California Trail Center notes that many people would turn up sick at breakfast and be dead by dinner. Today, cholera is easily treated if you have access to clean fluids and electrolytes. According to CNN, about 80% of cholera cases can be successfully treated this way, and there are actually several vaccines available to prevent the disease. More importantly, cholera is extremely rare in developed nations. The CDC, for example, reports that in the United States, most cases of cholera are actually contracted in foreign countries. And CNN notes that in 2019, there were 0 cases in the US. That's great for us, but the rest of the world isn't so lucky. In 2019, there were over 923,000 reported cases of cholera in 55 countries, resulting in 1,911 deaths. But the bottom line is that if you get cholera and you're not a 19th century farmer making a brutal journey west in search of a better life, you've got an excellent chance of surviving. Diphtheria is a disease caused by airborne bacteria, meaning you breathe it in. You then walk around breathing and coughing the bacteria into other people for a while. After a few days, you'll develop cold-like symptoms and a fibrous coating begins to grow in your throat, making it hard to breathe. The coating can also grow over the nose and eyes. It kills about 10% of people who contract it. It's unsurprising that it was a major killer on the Oregon Trail, according to the Encyclopedia Britannica. A study on childhood vaccine development published in Pediatric Research reports that in the latter 19th century, it still had a fatality rate in children of 42% to 49%. Luckily, there's a reason you've never heard of diphtheria outside the game. An effective antitoxin for treating diphtheria was developed in the late 19th and early 20th centuries, and the CDC reports that the modern-day vaccination has pretty much eradicated the disease in the US. There's some bad news on the horizon, unfortunately. According to researchers at the University of Cambridge, diphtheria is developing antibiotic resistance and cases are on the rise, doubling from 8,105 cases in 2017 to 16,651 cases in 2018. That's stoking fears the disease might stage a vaccine escape. Dysentery kills you so often in the Oregon Trail, it's no wonder the disease was most associated with the game. And once you learn a bit about dysentery, you kind of understand why it's so deadly. The disease is largely spread through contaminated water and food, and incubates for a few days before hitting its victims suddenly with fever, inflamed intestines, and a near-constant bloody diarrhea that can quickly lead to death via dehydration.
There's definitely worse ways to go.
Amen.
Dysentery was no party.
According to the World Health Organization, dysentery today is considered one variation of diarrheal diseases. These diseases are collectively the number one cause of death in children globally, killing more than 500,000 every year. And the WHO notes that the bacterial form afflicts about 165 million people every year, killing around 1.1 million. Surprisingly, according to the National Center for Biotechnology Information, there are still 450,000 cases of bacterial dysentery in the United States annually. There's no cure, and so far no vaccine to prevent dysentery. What makes this incredibly tragic is that if treated early, the disease is usually survivable, but delays in diagnosis often lead to more severe cases, and it's entirely preventable through safe drinking water, proper hygiene, and basic food preparation precautions.